On July 7, 1984, a 353-member Chinese Olympic delegation stood before Vice President Ulan Hu and Vice Premier Wan Li, days away from embarking on a voyage that would bring the results of China's growth as a sports power to the world stage in a way that had never been realized before. Speaking about the size of the delegation, Vice Premier Li said, "This, in itself, shows the enormous development in sports in China."
在中国体育代表的参加洛杉矶奥运会之前，全国人民欢欣鼓舞，希望中国在这洛杉矶奥运会上面有零的突破。这是几亿人的梦想，也就是中国参加奥运会几十年以后的梦想，希望能够在洛杉矶奥运会上有所突破，能够取得良好的成绩。全国人民盼望我们的奥运健儿
China was about to achieve for its people the third of four dreams which had been envisioned more than 60 years before by Zu-Liang Sung, Honorary Secretary of the Chinese National Amateur Athletic Federation. Zu-Liang had already achieved his first dream when China attended the Olympics with a single athlete in 1932. His second dream came true when China sent a team to the Olympics in 1936. Sadly, Zu-Liang would not be alive to witness the realization of his third dream, for China to win a gold medal at the Olympics. Among the delegation about to leave for the 1984 Los Angeles Olympics, however, was Weiliang Jiang, Zu-Liang's nephew, a journalist who would travel to LA to cover the Olympics for the China Daily.
So 1984 is the day the Olympic game was held in Los Angeles again. This time, my father was appointed by the newspaper. He said, "Hey, this time I want to send you to the Los Angeles to report the Olympic." My father suddenly said, is this real? Because this time my father has never got the opportunity to report the Olympic game. Then he called from Beijing. This time he is Beijing. The family is, my mother and I was in Shanghai. He called from Beijing to tell my mother, "Hey, this time I went to the United States." But after this, my mother said, "How you go again?" He said, "Yes, this time you don't know. You don't realize what's important for me. Because this time I report the Olympic gaming. You know Olympic gaming? It's different than other games." Then I said, "Oh, Olympic game. You mentioned it many times to me." Then I was there. I said, "Where is the game take place?" They said, "It's in Los Angeles. It's the same place your grand uncle was there. Many, many years ago. This is the first time the Chinese people went to the Olympic game. It's also in the Los Angeles. That early years, when the grand uncle was there, he do some things in there, and this time I want to do things, some things too special." So he prayed a lot of time.
Not having attended a Summer Olympics for 32 years, China made sure that the delegation sent in 1984 would be fully trained, fully prepared, and fully equipped.
1984. This is the first time the Chinese government sent a so big delegation to the Olympic Games. So besides the athletes, they also a very big media group. Everybody speak very good English during that time, because my father was one of the member of the delegation. So he's very proud of it. He got some badges and some, also he got a very nice watch. It's especially for the delegation members. This is the Seagulls, the watch was manufactured in the Tianjin. They have the Olympic rings and the China flag on behind the watch. That's a very interesting one. Before the delegation was left to the Los Angeles, my father tell me, this time, you know, maybe the China can got some medals, the real medals. This time, maybe your grand uncle will be very happy because the third dream will become true.
The Chinese team had been instructed to win as many gold medals as they could. Now, with a roster of record-breaking athletes such as Zhu Qianhua, who had won several world championships over the preceding years, prospects seemed very good for an excellent showing by the Chinese team.
所以呢，只希望能够多拿眼奖吧。不过，搿趟奥运会
中国也希望能够多拿眼奖吧。每次比赛嘛，运动员也要重视，教练、领导侪重视，侪希望能够多拿眼金牌。
On July 28, 1984, in spite of a Soviet Union-led boycott, the 23rd Olympic Summer Games opened at the Los Angeles Memorial Coliseum with an estimated audience of 2.5 billion television viewers worldwide. A record-breaking 140 nations and regions had shown up, with 6,829 athletes who would compete over the coming weeks in 221 events. At the head of the parade was Greece, the birthplace of the Olympics. Loud applause was heard when the Chinese delegation, led by basketball player Wang Libing, entered the stadium. On the same track where Liu Chongchuan had represented his country as its single athlete 52 years before, 212 Chinese athletes now proudly marched behind their country's five-star red flag. And among the 9,190 media representatives on hand to cover the glory of the day was Weiliang Jiang.
所以我爸爸呢，我可以讲，伊是相当相当激动，因为当伊晓得，当因为辣辣那个洛杉矶呢，伊是同一个城市当初，对吧？又是同一个运动场，搿个运动场呢，就是名字改脱了。我爸爸当时去的辰光，伊并不晓得是同一个运动场，后来资料查下来，发现是同一个运动场的话，伊真的是相当激动。伊辣辣运动场上，伊回来跟阿拉讲了，伊讲一直晓得有迭个四个迭个梦想，迭个第三个梦想呢，终于拨伊碰上了。而且伊介好机会，伊就是去目睹了迭个第三个梦想的发生。迭个辰光呢，辣辣迭个开幕式辰光，伊看到有介许多个中国人搿能走进来，啊，伊搿个当时激动得不得了。因为伊想同一个运动场，自家介许多年数，搿球球辣辣介许多年数前头是第一次，也是一个团长进来辰光，也是一个中国代表队。迭个辰光运动员只有一个人。八四年个辰光，伊辣辣迭个看台高头看下去个。就是一个是恰气度过中国真正意义的南京人嗷嗷大的啊好多了的，所以一个是激动的心情呢，是我是能够理解的，而且一回来讲，一当时这个照相机设备也没搞好，现在是短个镜头，一捏着这照相机都忙起来拍照，一直到队伍差不多要走光了，刚刚想着一个快点要个拍照了，巴拉巴拉再进过去。
在整个运动场比赛场地呢是蛮激动的了，交关观众坐了海。但自家呢，对搿场比赛呢，也已经期盼了已久了，就希望能够每天希望能够比赛早点到来了，老期盼搿场比赛。但是进了比赛场以后，看介许多观众的情况下头呢，哪能讲法？有点就是讲紧张。但真的比赛了以后呢，就啥个事体侪忘记脱了，就只想到希望就能够变得好点了。比赛当中，我也觉得跟平常正常的比赛也没啥特别的区别了。
我们中国就是第一次这个拿到了奥运会的金牌第一枚，那就是真了不起的。
人民生活也是提高了，国家也富强了。冠军也多起来了，
让我们的就是中国的体育精神发扬到全世界去，然后对于我们中国人来说，就是让整个世界认识新的中国，
中国人民的努力。
Now that the games had officially opened, excitement at home ran high with hopes that China would be able to hold its head high in this major international event. As it turned out, the world would not have to wait long to witness the huge improvements in sports training which now made China, once the sick man of Asia, a major contender in the world's arena. On the first day of competition, the first gold medal of the 23rd Olympiad was won by Xu Hai Feng in the men's free pistol event.Accepting his award, Xu said, I am very proud to have won this medal, and I thank the people back home for their trust in me. And back home, celebrations broke out in the streets.
I was not in Shanghai with my mother. I was doing some business job in the Sichuan province. But I was there to see this opening ceremony. I was very happy. You see, hey, I can see on the TV that time. Actually, I got the news that Xu Hai Feng got their first medal on that game, the gold medal. That I was not from the TV set. I was through this, I got the news from the radio. I remember that day when I come back from the company, I was negotiating with some business friends, then come back to the hotel. Say everybody is there, say, hey, China win the gold medal, China win the gold medal. This is very happy, everybody is very happy. So that night I just remember, say everybody open the bottle of wine, they drink a beer, so I like very happy there.
当徐海峰在第二十三届洛杉矶奥运会上面为中国人夺得第一名金牌的时候，我非常震撼，我激动地流泪了，因为中国人终于是站起来了，他拿金牌证明了中国是一个不朽的、辉煌的、古老的民族。
As exciting as the win was for all of China, few would appreciate the significance of the moment more than Weiliang Jiang.As he stood in the very stadium from which his uncle, Zu-Liang Sung, had left empty-handed 52 years before, witnessing the fulfillment of a personal dream that had become the dream of a nation.
当后来这个徐海峰啊，得了第一块金牌以后，伊就帮我写了，伊正好这个辰光记者嘛，就写了一篇文章。后来伊讲，实际上我篇文章写了一塌糊涂，啥道理啊？搿辰光激动得来是没办法用语言来表达搿种。伊讲可以讲搿篇报道呢是一直想写个物事，但是呢是写了顶笔脚篇。
姜伟良先生，他作为《中国日报》的体育部的主任，他在1984年第二十三届洛杉矶奥运会上，亲眼目睹了徐海峰得到第一面的金牌，发回来了第一篇的报道，作为他，也就是走上了他的亲舅舅。在52年以前，同一个赛场，他实现了他的梦想，他继承了他舅舅的这个遗志，到了奥林匹克赛场，做出了奥林匹克的贡献。
徐海峰呢，是在奥运会上，二十三届，84年洛杉矶奥运会呢，获得了这个第一枚金牌，中国人呢实现了这个金牌零的突破，确实非常振奋，确实当时记忆很深，应该讲的到现在为止呢，对徐海峰的印象还是非常深。因为从我们这代人，就是我这个年龄呢，也是50年代初出生的。那么84年洛杉矶奥运会呢，我记得当时呢，我们是在这个一艘这个江轮上，就是从重庆到武汉，信号呢不是很好，因为一直在这个动，所以说我们经常会出去呢去动动天线，就是包括就是看这个记忆最深的就是中国女排，夺冠那场比赛，当时的记忆非常深。再一个呢，就是84年呢，当时我和菲利普蒋先生的这个相识呢，也就是在那次船上相遇的。当时他也非常兴奋，因为他也跟我们讲到，就是说中国运动员夺得了第一枚金牌，就是说他的父亲蒋维良先生呢，也是去洛杉矶这个报道这个奥运会。那么再加上呢，我和蒋先生呢，我们之间当时年轻人，而且呢就有很多共同语言，尤其是体育方面的共同语言比较多，包括在一起在一块儿这个交流，一块儿看这个电视转播世界瞩目的运动会，确实非常的兴奋。
China would go on to win a total of 32 medals at the 23rd Summer Olympiad, 15 gold, 8 silver, and 9 bronze, a finish that would have made Zu-Liang Sung extremely proud.Many memorable moments had been created for audiences back home, most notably by gymnast Li Ning, who took 3 gold, fencer Luan Juje, and the women's volleyball team, which would defeat the Americans in a rousing final match.
在84年洛杉矶奥运会上面，中国代表团得了15块的金牌，使我们中国人心情特别的振奋，感到就是说，我们中国的体育健儿能够在奥运会上面。取得那么辉煌的成绩，这是非常了不起的事情。也就是说，我们中国人可以在奥运会的舞台上面更好的大显身手，为我们备战今后的奥运会起到了积极的促进的作用。
Before returning to China, Weiliang Jiang would pay a visit to his uncle's grave in San Francisco to pay homage to the man who had dreamed of this moment so many years before. The beloved hero of a family, and now,The unsung hero of a nation.
After the game is finished, he left the Los Angeles, then went to the San Francisco, where my grand auntie still lived there. The whole family with my father, they went to the graveyard, my grand uncle.
So they went there, tell my grandma, uncle, say, hey, your dream is really come true. Then one day China maybe will hold the game. We are just waiting for the time will come.
I think that the Chinese have proven they can do just about anything they set their minds to. And I see a lot of things in the news that lead me to believe that the Chinese people and the Chinese government are working very hard together to put on a good show and to show the world what the Chinese people can do. So I expect that they're going to do very well, and good for them.
China's showing at the 1984 Olympics had, in several ways, helped move the country closer to the achievement of Zu-Liang Sung's greatest dream, for China to host the Olympics. The nation had conducted itself honorably at the Games and, by its presence, had shown the world that China was an important international player, and not only in sports. Widespread adoration back home at the return of China's heroes from the world arena further acted to popularize sports development in the country, leading to greater investment in sports at many levels.
After 1956, China was broken from the Olympic Committee. From that time to 1984, they don't have any activities between the Chinese team involved in the Olympic Games. So this time, when they come back to the Olympic family, this is the first time, actually, in the People's Republic of China to send a so big delegation to the Olympic Games. So everybody hope this time will be a good chance for the Chinese team to perform well in the game. They all also want some gold medals from there too.
那么说到这个在赛场上呢永不放弃永不言败这种这个例子呢很多啊大家这个印象最深的像这个刘国正啊和这个金蜘蛛的比赛挽救了七个赛点最后是挽救了整个比赛挽救了整个中国队最后呢是反败为胜中国队取胜啊包括是孟观良他们那个皮划艇也是在最后一刻他们还是一直在奋力的这个划着啊但是到最后呢到了终点以后他们自己也不知道到底是第几名但是当队友告诉他第一名的时候他们确实是那个非常兴奋当时这个大家呢对观众呢也是非常的这个振奋那我觉得就是这种精神呢是在运动场上的运动员一定要体现出来就是永不言败永不放弃
From the participation of a single Chinese athlete Liu Chongchuan who more than 50 years before had left Los Angeles with Zu-Liang Sung without a single medal to show for their efforts The Chinese team had, in 1984, demonstrated itself a powerhouse of achievement and good sportsmanship. A greater appreciation had been formed of the country due to its ability to field such a team.
When he was in the Los Angeles, he visited the village, the Olympic village, where the athletes lived there. He met the old woman. It's almost 70 years old, say more than 70 years old. This woman is very special. He is a volunteer work there, work in the village. He also worked for the 1932 Olympic Games in the Los Angeles. My father told him, hi, I'm very happy when from the China Daily, from China, to report the Olympic Games. then tell the the lady, say, you know, my uncle was the first Chinese man lead the athletes to the Olympic game. Then the late old lady tell my father, he said, I remember the Chinese people is Liu Changcheng. He's a very good athlete. Another official, the name is William, because during that time, my grand uncle used another, he has an English name called William. So then my father said, hey, William is my uncle. So the lady is very excited. The old lady said, you are very lucky one. I'm very lucky one. We both can enjoy the game. I can witness twice the game, the Olympic game, was happening in Los Angeles. I was part of them, the twice. It's very happy.
公安的运动员，对中国的所谓，对中国的运动员，现在不是哪能去了解嘛？阿拉能够通过介许多运动员代表中国，走出中国的国门，代表中国的到国外去比赛，等于代表中国的形象了。可能这个人家公安的观众，伊老早子可能也不晓得有中国搿能个国家。 也不晓得有中国队呢，有介许多运动员来参加，所以侬看介许多中国运动员穿了老整齐的服装，然后呢人长了长长大大的，能够在比赛当中取得好的成绩，所以呢对中国的刮目相看了，所以呢能够更加了解中国，也等于是对国外来讲，阿拉跑出去也宣传中国。
My father always think before after the 1984, he said. He always tell me, he said, the third dream is already done. So we are waiting for the last dream when the China will hold the game. So we always waiting the day will come. My father always said, hey, I'm old. I want to come, the dream will come earlier as possible. I'm saying, hey, I'm young enough, I can wait. But everybody is very confident one day China will hold the game.